Electric vehicles have been a major tool for reducing carbon footprints within the transportation sector. From electric bicycles to the 2018 summer of electric scooters, Tesla's Cybertruck to Einride's electrified self-driving freight vehicle, the electrification trend means most of our future mobility relies on power from lithium-ion batteries.
Everything is getting electrified these days. Rechargeable lithium-ion batteries are in everything, from any electrified vehicle, be it even bus, truck, all the way down to passenger vehicle, now marine even, and of course, around us in our everyday lives. Even the camera I'm sure that's being powered right now is from lithium-ion battery.
We call it a battery, and most people think of it as just a thing. The battery will actually consist of upwards to 100 components sometimes, and these are 100 unique components.
The mass demand for lithium-ion batteries was marked notably by the threefold increase in the global price of lithium between 2016 and 2018. Adoption was rapid. People were eager to demonstrate their support for a cleaner future, which was one with very few fossil fuels involved. And they were right. Electric cars present a massive improvement of emissions when compared with traditional combustion engines. The tricky part is when we consider what happens to the car and its parts when it's done being used.
These things will die at some point and need to be recycled. And traditionally, up until now, this has been via a high temperature process, the way they've been recycled, and typically only recovered 50% of the materials within. So on a go-forward basis, that's very inefficient.
With the whole idea to reuse a battery, you actually need to repackage it for its new application. You can't really stick a car battery on the side of a house. It doesn't quite work like that.
Lithium-ion batteries, the current industry standard for battery packs, contain precious metals such as lithium, nickel, and cobalt. When it comes time to replace the battery, often it is no longer usable, but the precious metals within can be mined and recycled. The current recycling rate average is 50% worldwide, and the process of recovering the materials is often incredibly energy intensive. We're going to take a look at two startups tackling different parts of the lithium-ion battery lifecycle. One company from Birmingham called Aceleron has made news with its intelligent design that means their batteries can be easily serviced and dismantled for reuse. The idea came when the founders Amrit and Carlton realized the most batteries were not designed with maintenance in mind. So they created the battery for the circular economy.
So we kind of evaluated and also identified that most of the time for mobility applications, battery is no longer considered viable after it reaches, let's say, 20% degradation, because it just doesn't have the oomph. So we evaluated, what if we created a reuse process for that?
Another company called Lifecycle from Mississauga, Canada, has developed a two-step recovery process for lithium and other precious metals. They claim it can recover 80 to 100% of precious metals from the used batteries, compared with the average success rate of about 50%. This massive improvement on battery efficiency means that they can be easily reused. And it's steady work. The company states that they already have more batteries than they have the capacity to recycle. This is a problem the founder calls a good one. We met AJ Kochar at the World Energy Congress in Abu Dhabi, and he explained to us how the Lifecycle system works.
So we do it via two technologies. One is a mechanical technology, where we take batteries, we break them down into inert material. And then the second technology is where we take that inert material and then we re-recover the chemicals again, so lithium, nickel, cobalt, etc. And those two are actually two separate technologies. This is like a hub and spoke model, like a wheel. So the spoke is the satellite sites where we break down the battery, make an inert material. And then the hub is where we consolidate all that and then convert into chemicals.
At the beginning of January 2020, the company announced their first shipment of metals recovered via their trademarked process. While the rapid adoption of electrification of vehicles marks an important turning point in the race to improve sustainability, we've still got a long way to go. There are other aspects of the lithium-ion battery production cycle to consider, including the energy-intensive mining process. Further, the demand for these batteries is only expected to increase, meaning more waste on the horizon. But with the expansion of innovations like the ones from Lifecycle and Aceleron, we can mitigate some or even all of the lithium-ion battery waste, a number one consulting firm quoted at 1.2 million metric tons by the year 2030. Till next time.